facilities wing. All right, Ada. I think it's time for you to work your magic again. Because I have a feeling that's where we're going.
Oh, and I'm the type of guy who will never settle down. Where pretty girls are, well, you know that I'm around.
So, no less paranoid. I mean, really, at this point, if they've got this far... I suppose it's not actually the mechanist that's paranoid, it's whoever built this place, isn't it? Right.
If you find any spare parts, you be sure and let me know.
Yeah. Everything's a spare part. Depends on how you look at it. I really think we should just focus on staying alive and getting the job done and come back and do looting. What do you think? I mean, if we see anything really, really obvious, we can sort of take it, but...
The Commonwealth is right to fear people!
Oh! Oh, he was going to talk to us. That probably wasn't important. Servo mech, we got something coming, something. I want to loot. I'm a terrible person. Quantum scrap bot. Oh god. Let's do it. Look at this, it's... Oh, don't think I'm actually using it. Just... It's crap. It is crap. Total crap. I'm really annoyed with that. I want to loot this. Why would... Thank you! Let me loot it. You are not serious. I know, I shouldn't be bothered about... Ah, got it. But it was there, glowing blue, mocking me. Yes, it was. Ooh. Ooh, you know what that means? Level 63. That means I can take the last rat. Are you okay? You don't look okay. Oh. What the hell just happened? How the hell did I just end up here? I've got two... Oh! Oh, really? Oh, I didn't realize I had a perk. I can take the last rank of blacksmith, which is good, because then I can make... I am now the ultimate engineer, kind of. I have. Blacksmith maxed. Armorer maxed. I don't have... No, that is it, isn't it? That's the melee weapons. I've got gun nut maxed. Science maxed. Robotics maxed. I don't have nuclear physicist, but I guess that's not really engineering, although... Making cores last long just seems so pointless at this stage. Basically, my thinking now is that I would kind of like to try automatic weapons. I'm thinking things like my 10mm automatic pistol. Imagine how devastating that thing would be. Maxed out, if I double this, if I take all the ranks in this, I get 100% more damage plus a chance to stagger opponents. But remember, that's actually an explosive pistol, and I do double the damage on the explosions for double the area as well, so that's going to become staggeringly good. I'm thinking big sale, partly because it gets me more money, and more money's always useful, but also because the... This perk is required to build certain things in the settlement. It's things I don't really need, but it's that completionist side of me that's thinking, oh, that would be good. Scrounger, find more ammunition. Who doesn't like more ammunition? But at this point, I have to wonder, is that truly something I care too much about? I am buying the ammunition for the Gauss rifle and for the plasma rifle. I'm constantly buying it to keep it ahead, and I think I would run out if I didn't. Maybe taking another rank would make it so that I just didn't need to buy, but that's not really that big a problem. So, I almost feel like that's a waste of a perk. I've even got enough rockets. I mean, I've got 140 rockets. I've got quite a few nukes. And I'm not even going to use the nukes, I don't think. I really just don't think it's a very situational weapon. I'm not bringing it anymore. But there's also things like basher. Do more damage when bashing. This could be interesting, especially if I upgrade my power armor, which I can, and I can bash for less action points. Honestly, though, I think what I'm going to save that perk, because if I do go the automatic route, I'm going to use them all at once. I'm going to wait till I've got at least 4, maybe 5 perks and spend it at once. But right now, I've kind of... Oh, the other option. Charisma perks to intimidate people. But honestly, just... I'm not feeling that at the moment. I originally was, but... not anymore. Okay. I don't know why it went into the perk menu at that point. Did I get everything from there? Why am I doing it that way? Okay, they're playing Pong! They're actually playing Pong! And he's not alarming. Oh, because somebody's put... that's genius! Somebody's found a way to shut him up. Without shooting him in the head. Genius. Okay, I was going to worry about looting later, wasn't I? Within reason? Can we say within reason? Like, green paint. Another robot repair thing? Yeah, I'm looting, I know. But I can't use this. It says... you cannot use this workshop yet. We're going to get control of this place. Stop looting. Stop looting. You're only stealing your own stuff. Am I seeing gas shimmer, or is that just... I don't think so. Yeah, I'm only looting my own stuff at this point, I think. Okay, radioactive water... terminal. It's just too bright, isn't it? Nope. Right, so we've got power substation A terminal. Why do I know we're probably going to need to set power up somehow? That's probably what we're going to have to do, right? Okay. So, we can probably ignore this right now. Let's just read it to see if there's any instructions. But if it says activate, let's not until we find out what the hell we're doing. Okay. What a waste. I've been down here almost 4 months now and I'm already getting bored. I thought it would be exciting to sign up and work for the robotics program, but when I finally got my departmental assignment, I almost quit. Power Substation A, are you kidding me? 4 years of electrical engineering school and they have me babysit a bunch of generators. I can strip a Mr. Handy or Protectron down to its base parts in under 2 hours and they stick me here. What a goddamn waste of time. Cunning plan. I have a cunning plan. Should call you Baldrick from now on. After talking too sharply during my smoke break, I thought of a way to turn my isolation into an advantage. Actually, it was Blackadder used to say that, wasn't it? And he would steal Baldrick's plans. Maybe. It was a while ago. I've got a buddy in the civilian service who works for a vending company and he reckons that I can make a few bucks if I stick one of his cigarette machines down here. It would save everyone a trip all the way to the surface if they're out of smokes and give me an excuse to say hi to any of the ladies that happen to wander in to purchase some. I'll tell you, Sharpley's a goddamn genius. I might even have to comp him a few free packs for his help. Okay. Substation B. I took all the trouble to sneak that machine into my substation just to have Banks over at Substation B start complaining about the smoke. At first I thought he was just jealous of all the ladies that had been hanging around my new cigarette machine during their smoke breaks. Then he showed all his cards when he told me that he's going to lodge a formal complaint with Delano if I don't make him happy. He doesn't care about the smoke, sneaky little thief, just wants a cut of the cigarette sales. I might have to pay him off to keep the brass off my back. Official approval. Finally got official approval to keep the cigarette machine in my substation. I'm pretty sure the free cartons that found their way onto the general's desk may have had something to do with it. Now Banks can't do a damned thing about it, and he isn't getting a single penny. Looks like this electrical engineer just came out on top for once. Okay, so I don't get to turn the power on from here. Oh, okay. I sort of assumed when I saw the terminal that I would be rebooting power or something. Not reading one man's sneaky... Where's his cigarette machine? Where was it? Okay. It's not. Not here. It must be outside. Let's have a look. Alright, where is it? I'm not seeing it. You loot those things, you see. Or am I seeing it? I'm just completely missing it. Definitely a possibility. That's going to annoy me now. That is actually going to annoy me. Yes, it is. Does it look different? Does it not look the same as the usual cigarette machines? It's a special bending one. No. Probably not. And he said he liked the fact that they were hanging around near him. So he would have thought it would be round here. Oh! It's acting as a coffee table for the ammo. Okay, fair enough. It was hiding. It was pretending... A small table. I'm not looting, am I? I gotta do it.
Make sure you don't leave anything useful behind.
Oh, you see? Okay, I was about to gloat and say, see? If I hadn't looted, I would have missed that little model. It was just... Instinct that said, must loot. Do the looting. Okay, so we got a scrap bot. Stop hitting! I'm going to confiscate your Gatling laser. I really am. He was on our side for now. You're a little slow with that sort of thing, aren't you? Is that glowing? Can I use that? No. Here we go. Do you think there's like a bobblehead stand for robots? Because if not, we need one. Yes, we do. Parts warehouse. It doesn't look like it's in very good shape. Okay. Power armor repair. I wonder, do you think I... Well, I don't think I've taken that much damage, have I? Okay. Any ammo? Ada, please. I'm having enough difficulty seeing. Put my light on. Okay, that's for the warehouse. Oh. I was going to say, let's check the warehouse before we continue on our way there. But apparently not. Are you getting that ominous feeling of... Oh! Damn it. So close. Okay, probably... Easiest way to do this. Yeah. Okay, what the hell? Right, we got something else? Where? Is that a... Ada, what the hell are you doing? Where? Ada! Bring me back something nice. Okay.
You may be getting closer, but I will not falter. My robots will see to it that no further harm will come to the Commonwealth. I believe that good will always overcome evil. Justice will prevail today.
Okay. So this loony thinks he's doing the Commonwealth a favor, really, doesn't it? Yes, he does. Okay. Well, why can't I build one of those? I want to build an iBot. I want to build an iBot. I want to build an Eddie. All right, let's... Facilities management, all right. And... you? We've got a lot of assault trump parts. Oh, okay. Whoa, okay. Okay. Got ya. You are mine. Until I find something bigger and scarier. Okay? No. I made you... What? Oh, is it not in sight? I shouldn't incite you. I should command you. Incite just makes you attack everything in sight. Is that what it is? No? Command? Yeah, no, right. Incite makes you attack everything in sight, I think. Command... I'm not gonna blow up, are you? No, okay. Protect on front, actuated brain. Alright, so don't incite them from now on. It'll just incite them to attack everything. But surely command gets them to attack everything. As well? No? Okay. More of those generator things. So this is just gonna take. Oh! Fusion core removed. And save that to sell it. Okay. So that's where we came, isn't it? For the iBot. Ah. Probably can't get there without doing a little bit of hopping and jumping. That looks a bit. Okay, let's just scout the place before we start. Gas! Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we've got gas. And this is... Oh, it's going to take us in that direction. That's what that's going to do. Right, I got it. This is a platform that takes us across. Okay, so let's take a look around here in facilities management. And see what we can do. I'm going to obviously loot the area. I know, I said I wasn't going to. I lied. I'm a terrible person.
Hey.
But you get used to it. So I am like totally overloaded now, as is Ada. Okay. Unit tasks. Scrap retrieval, repairs, loading dock, currently awaiting orders, disposal. Alright, is that important? Doesn't seem important. Repair orders. Experiencing voice distortion. I think I've probably killed everything. Assigned to D. Delano, J. McDaniel. None. Are any of these names going to be names I'm discovering later on? Is the mechanist one of these people? Okay. Who knows? So. Shall we leave our friend here, or do we take her with? Will she follow? If I leave her here and come back later, will she be hostile? Does she have parts that I would like to use? Where's the button? There it is. Okay. Are you going to come? Come on. You know you want to. You see, if we come back later and she's hostile, it's just going to be slightly annoying. Probably because I won't be expecting it and I'll get shot whilst not wearing armor. Which kind of reminds me. find it. Okay. That wasn't too bad. Bit more loot. And not a lot else. Okay. Ah, we got another door for you. Tell you what.
Over here.
You open that while I do a quick check that I've not been... Oh, God. You kind of scared me a little. Okay. Oh, right. Right, right, right. We're going lower and lower in this big room, aren't we? That's locked. We're going through there by the, by the looks of things and by the simple fact that I don't think there's anywhere else to go. There's a cage there. What? Okay. It's a little weird sounding. There is a cage there, so they were keeping things locked up.
Over here.
That thing's not... They don't, it doesn't run out, does it? Is it? Has it got a time limit? That would be unfortunate, because it's going to shoot us in the... Yes, let the integrated scrap bot go first. Okay. Do we have... Right, what have we got here? Property storage lockup terminal. Ooh, we're going to be going through there, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, we are. I know, my pla... Oh, I see. Oh! My plan was to do all the looting later. For feature, terminal, password. And Mr. Gutsy model. All right, okay, well, we're going to do some more looting as well before we carry on, I think, because... Okay, so what, can we close that? Let's do the looting first, because that was kind of creepy looking. Yeah, I've given up with the whole I'm not going to loot on the way... thing. I'm totally petrified I won't be able to come back here, even though I suspect, from the looks of things, he's going to let me take over. I really shouldn't have the messages saying workshop not allowed yet. I mean, really. Spoilers. So. Ammo. Oh, not just ammo. Oh god, wrong. A robot's part model. Military ammo bag. What do military ammo bags have in them? Oh! Rockets! Rockets! No, out of my way! I don't know what the ammo bags have, but it says the scrap, so I can use them for something. Move! Do not come between me and loot, especially when loot's ammo. Oh, come on, you get. I can't even want to use my jetpack. Oh, really? Just got it. Annoying things. Okay, what have we got here? 10mm auto pistol. Radex. Didn't really need that. Baseball bat mahogany. Oh. Ooh. Do you know what's always a bad sign? And it is, it's just a basic truism. Bad sign when you find a serious cache of... Well, not gold, but a serious cache of ammo. It usually means you are about to need lots of ammo. It's one of the weird things about the universe. Never ever in the history of ever as a hero made it to a seriously hard fight without ammo. always conveniently placed ammo somewhere on the way for said hero to pick up. I'm assuming all that would have done was... I've already got the password. I'm assuming that would have meant I didn't need to spend all that time picking the lock, because I did have the password. I'm thinking the sea captain's hat would suit Ada. I don't know why. Not the bowler hat, but the sea captain's hat. I've got loads of them. I don't know why I picked that one up. But I don't think she'll wear hats, I'm afraid. Oh. Oh. Well, that person was oddly packed. Okay, no, this is America. Let's just you know, I don't know. Everyone has bobby pins and ammo, apparently. It's just the thing. That and serious amounts of medication. Could you please? Thank you. Right, we've got watch station terminal. Okay. They're offloading another set of subjects, quotes this time, to us today. I don't know what these men and women did to deserve being sent here, but since they were transferred from civilian penitentiaries. So they weren't sending brains from dead people. They were sending people who were soon to be dead people. Okay, that's pretty twisted. I can only assume that the worst society has to offer. I wouldn't assume that. Chances are you're working for the worst that society has to offer. I don't think these people had any idea what's about to happen to them. One thing's for sure, these prisoners would have been better off serving their time elsewhere. I don't think they're going to serve their time. I think they're going to end for their time. I'm starting to hear rumors around the block that I don't like. Esteban told me that he overheard two of the eggheads saying that the prisoners are having their brains cut out of their heads or something like that. I know that the brass is running experiments on these inmates and that they were pretty intense, but I didn't know they were literally cutting them open. I'm not sure how I feel about that. Badly. You feel bad. After all, I joined the military because I wanted to serve my country and protect my fellow Americans. I guess I'll keep it to myself for now. No. Run outside and go, we're doing evil, horrible things here. But no, don't do that because you'll get shot. Blog about it anonymously. The rumors floating around the block are getting worse. One of our informants said that the prisoners are talking about rioting. If the things that they're saying are true, the inmates are getting dissected and the parts used for robots. I almost can't say that I blame them. Almost can't say you blame them? Like you sat there going, you know, I probably wouldn't riot myself if someone was going to chop me up and use my parts for robots, but I kind of understand why some people might. Esteban said we should go right to Gamma 9 status, but I don't want to push the panic button unless I absolutely have to. I've decided to take this and all the way to the top and meet with General Rawlings. Criminals or not, these experiments are wrong and they need to be stopped before it's too late. Okay. Broderick got reassigned out of the facility today. I think they're having him scrubbing toilets at some backwater listening post in Anchorage now. They put me in charge of the cell block and I initiated Gamma 9 status. After 2 days, the threat of rioting has ended and everything is back to normal. The brass gave me the go-ahead to start sending people to the medical section and everything is proceeding as planned. If we have any hope of beating the enemy at their own game, we need to get these robots online. Okay, this was someone else then. Personal log, Raymond Oh! Right. This is Esteban. Cares what happened to a few lousy inmates. I told Broderick he needed to fall in line, but he wouldn't listen. Of all people, I would have expected him to understand that the needs of the many outweighed the needs of the few. Alright, so Esteban took over. And Esteban believes that the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few, and that they're criminals and they should be eradicated. You don't think Esteban is the mechanist, do you? Could be. Alright, I think that's everything I got. Yeah. Okay. Let's go down the reddish mile. Okay. And yes, I'm going to check eventually check every single solitary cell just in case there's something useful. Some holotape that says, no, don't go that way!
Or die horribly.
It has nothing to do with the fact that there may be loot. No, it doesn't. It's a vicious lie. These are ghouls. Aren't they? They look like ghouls. So, the mechanist is probably a ghoulified, not test subject, but a ghoulified, it's probably Esteban, isn't it? It's going to be Esteban. Ghoulified and still convinced he can save humanity. Again, bobby pins. Bobby pins and drugs. Surprised you didn't have ammunition. We don't give prisoners ammunition, do we not? Really? Isn't that inhumane? Oh, good grief, talking about inhumane. Okay. Were you ghoulifying them first? No, no. The ghoul is a subject, but this is a RoboBrain operated cart. This isn't the brain from the feral ghoul. This is. Oh, you know what happened? Bombs dropped. The whole place shut down. The RoboBrain stopped. This was a human test subject. Probably lay here for such a long time, being irradiated, turning. Thank you. I'm really not keen on the noise you make. Oh, you're charging your face laser. Got it. Charging your face laser. That makes more sense. Yes, yes. It just sounds like you're about to go into a meltdown. Yeah, I realize I'm trying to figure out what's going on here. When all I really need to do is probably run in that direction very, very quickly and find out. But where would the fun of that be? You need to get there and the mechanist say, do you know who I am? And I go, yeah, you're Esteban. Just totally cool and casual about it.
Sweet.
Okay. Where are you going? Don't leave me alone with crazy here. What? Oh God. I'm taking it out. Slowly. Whoa. No. Let's just shut it down. Let's just shut it down. Okay, we've shut it down. She's kind of getting on my nerves a little bit. Mostly because she's stealing all my kills. Can't be having that. And it's just. Besides, the reason I need to kill him, you know. What happens if. Okay, that's just. You've been. I tell you what happens if I set the self-destruct whilst you're deactivated? Stand back. Yep. Oh, so that's where you do it. You shut them down, then you make them blow up. Or better still, make them aggressive to their own people. Hit the self-destruct, then jetpack out of there. Ooh. Good idea. Great idea. Okay. So let's just check all of the other cells for clues. Just clues, nothing but clues. Honest.
Nice.
You know, I should probably make nice. Some sort of robotic. I was waiting for that. Oh God, it's one of those. Charge! Oh, could you stop knocking him back into the wall? Thank you. I kept knocking him just as I was shooting him. Oh, God. Oh, there he is. Didn't have very good loot, anyway. Yeah, I needed some sort of robotic pick at this point. I'm a master lockpick. I'm a master roboticist engineer. Circuit breaker. Was that going to open all the cells? It did, didn't it? Okay, well, that's slightly annoying, isn't it? Oh, I should have thought that. It's a bloody prison. Okay, we got a door there, I guess, and... Okay. So we can see into the cells from above, which always seemed a little... creepy. Medical Observational Terminal. Alright, let's see. Subject A22. History: convicted of serial killings in the DC area. Not to be visited alone. Security personnel required for all interviews. Evaluation: A22 shows higher brain functioning but weaker constitution. We've given him a high protein diet and started sessions of electrotherapy to treat his muscles. It shouldn't be long until his brain survival rate for the procedure is no longer at risk. That's twisted. So, alright, so they are testing on the worst of the worst. But here's the thing, guys. Do you really think it's a good idea to use the brains of serial killers in your robots? Do you not watch horror movies ever? Convicted for arson, burned down a courthouse, leaving three dead, only approached when sedated. Yes, let's turn him into a killer robot. Evaluation: family medical history of dementia, brain health is likely to decline or skew data, recommended for termination. Convicted for murder of a waitress, prone to sudden outbursts of violence, recommend subject restraint at all times or sedated. Evaluation: highly emotional, currently on a cocktail of antidepressants and anti-anxiety. Dr. Astleford is starting psychiatric sessions to further see if she's a good candidate. Okay. 72. Convicted of second-degree murder while under the influence of alcohol. Alright, now you're not getting to sort of, you know, serial killers. Now you get some guy who killed someone whilst drunk. I'm not saying stand-up member of community, but I am saying shouldn't be dissected and brain stuck in a robot. None of these brains should be stuck in a robot anyway. Subject displays high intelligence and knowledge of tactics. Slight signs of PTSD. Dr. Astleford to evaluate for treatment. So probably... military. Oh, brilliant. History: ex-military convicted of second-degree manslaughter. Manslaughter. Assault resulting in hospitalization and later death of the victims. Evaluation: subject is highly intelligent and proved to be mentally sound. Approved candidacy. Oh yeah, sounds like the perfect brain to stick in a killer robot. Okay. Stealth boy. Okay. So, we've got a door. Oh no, we've got a terminal. I didn't check this. Oh no, because it's destroyed. That's fine. Okay. We have a door with a button in front of it. I think it's fairly obvious. Something horrible is going to come. Like an elevator. With a ghoul. And a... yeah, this is... I mean, is it aware? Does it... okay. So is this where we meet the evil super genius? He doesn't think of himself as evil. He thinks of himself as a superhero, doesn't he? The Mechanist. Okay. Right. Oh, hello. What was that? Research labs. This has got to be the final part. It just does, doesn't it? Look at it. It's gruesome. It's horrible. It's the research laboratory.